Catherine Tegan Books and Harper Audio present On Air with Zoe Washington by Janae Marks, performed by Bahni Turpin. To all of my amazing readers who asked for more of Zoe's story, this is for you. Excerpt from Boston Public Radio's Interview Hour with John Gallagher. Aired on June 20th. John Gallagher.
Welcome back to Boston Public Radio's Interview Hour. We're here with Marcus Johnson and his 14-year-old daughter, Zoe. Before the break, we talked to Marcus about how he was wrongfully convicted of murder 15 years ago and recently exonerated. Now I'd like to ask Zoe a few questions, since she actually played an important role in Marcus's release. Zoe, what made you want to investigate your father's crime in the first place? You were only, what, 12 years old at the time?
Zoe. Yep. Well, once I realized Marcus might be innocent of the crime, I had to know the truth. I'd never investigated anything before. But I don't know. I was just determined.
Marcus Johnson.
Zoe's very determined. I didn't want her looking into my case, but she did it anyway.
John. Laughter.
It's a good quality to have. Still, what you did is impressive for a kid.
Zoe.
I guess. But I had some help from my grandma and best friend, Trevor. What kept me going was how much I hated the idea of Marcus being in prison if he hadn't done anything wrong. Sometimes I think about what my life would have been like if he'd never been arrested for a crime he didn't commit. Like, what if he'd been able to be my dad my whole life? But at least now we get to have time together.
John.
When you first found out that Marcus was being exonerated, how did you feel?
Zoe.
When the judge read the verdict, I was in the courtroom, sitting in the row right behind Marcus. My parents were next to me. I think I screamed and then started crying when the judge said not guilty. It's kind of a blur now, but I was so excited.
John.
I bet.
Zoe.
It was like everything I did 2 years ago and all the waiting since then had finally paid off.
John.
Now that Marcus is out of prison, what do you look forward to the most?
Zoe.
So many things. Spending more time together in person, listening to music, cooking and baking. Actually, we both are working at Ari's Cakes in Beacon Hill this summer, so if you're listening, you should come by.
John.
Zoe brought some of her treats to the studio, so I can attest to how delicious her baking is. I will definitely make a trip out to Ari's Cakes. Well, thank you, Marcus and Zoe. We wish you both the best.
Music starts.
We'll be right back after these messages.
Chapter 1. If someone had told 10-year-old me that in 4 years I'd have a bakery job and that my birth dad, who I didn't even know at the time, would be my coworker, I would have looked at them like they had two heads. It was totally unbelievable. But now it was happening.
Hey, little T,
Marcus said as he got out of the passenger side of Grandma's car.
Hey, Big T. I gave him a hug.
Little T and Big T were our new nicknames for each other, short versions of Little Tomato, what Marcus called me when he wrote me letters from prison, and Big Tomato. We got into the car, and I said hello to Grandma. She had agreed to drive me and Marcus to Ari's Cakes, since Marcus had gotten his driver's license reactivated a week ago, but didn't have a car to drive yet. Ready to go?
Grandma asked from the driver's seat. Her earrings, which were made of small translucent shells, jangled as she twisted in her seat to talk to me.
Yep.
Are you excited? I asked Marcus from the back seat, or nervous?
I guess both, he said with a laugh, but more excited. It'll be nice to make cupcakes in the kitchen instead of the boring, tasteless meals I helped cook in prison.
Is that the only thing you're excited about? I asked. The baking?
Marcus pretended to think.
Yeah, he paused. I think that's it.
I leaned forward in my seat and nudged him in the shoulder. He laughed.
Of course I'm excited to work with you.
He looked back at me and smiled.
It's the best part of this whole job.
I smiled back.
Same here.
When we got to Beacon Hill, Marcus and I said goodbye to Grandma and walked inside the bakery. I breathed in the comforting smells of sugar and frosting mixed with coffee. I looked around the shop and soaked it all in. The cupcakes displayed behind the glass counter in a rainbow of colors, including my Fruit Loop cupcake recipe, which Ari still sold 2 years later. The pale blue walls that matched the Ari's Cakes t-shirt I was wearing. The little bud vases holding fresh flowers that sat on every table and next to the cash register. The ambient, cheery music playing lightly over the speakers. This was my home away from home. I waved at Gabe, who was currently taking orders. There were a few customers in line already.
Zoe, perfect timing, he said.
Hey, I said, I'm just gonna put my backpack away. I followed Marcus to the kitchen and left my bag in a cubby. Ariana waved at us from across the kitchen where she was helping Vincent with something.
Hey, you two. Marcus, grab an apron and come over. We have a big order to work on. Zoe, Gabe will get you settled up front.
Okay.
I stood there for a second and watched Marcus put his apron on over his jeans and black t-shirt. I wished I got to wear one, but since I wasn't working in the kitchen, it wasn't part of my uniform anymore. I was finally old enough to work full-time at the bakery all summer and get paychecks just like every other employee. But because I wasn't 16 years old, I wasn't legally allowed to bake in the kitchen. I'd gotten away with helping in the kitchen as an intern because I hadn't been an official employee. I'd only helped for a couple of hours once a week. Now that I was old enough, I had to follow the rules. I'd work Monday through Friday at the front of the shop. At least I'd get to do more than fold boxes and refill napkin dispensers. I was allowed to take cupcake orders, pack them, and use the cash register.
All right, little T, Marcus said. Wish me luck.
You don't need luck. You got this.
Marcus grinned wide.
You too.
As I stood there watching Marcus go over to Ariana and Vincent, I felt like the parent watching their kid go off to their first day of school. There was a tiny bit of envy in my gut since Marcus would get to bake. I wondered what the big order Ariana mentioned was, and if it involved a special recipe or interesting decorations. It suddenly hit me how much I wanted to bake instead of handing out the cupcakes up front. But there was nothing I could do about that. In 2 years, I'd be allowed to work in the kitchen again. And in the meantime, I'd bake as much as I could at home. Back up front, I dove right into work. The line of customers kept growing with the morning rush, so I helped pour coffee and box up cupcakes while Gabe worked the register. Once things quieted down, he showed me how the register worked. It was simple once I figured out which buttons to press.
How's it going out here? Ariana asked me a while later.
Great, I said.
Awesome.
If you want to take a lunch break now, you can. I told Marcus the same.
Okay.
Just then, Marcus came out of the kitchen without his apron.
Want to grab a slice of pizza or something?
He asked me.
Yes, please.
When we got outside, I pulled out my phone.
Who are you calling? Marcus asked.
Oh, I'm going to search for a pizza place. There's an app that tells you about the best restaurants in the area you're in.
Marcus laughed. Right. There are apps for everything.
He pulled his new cell phone out of his pocket.
Before I was in prison, I had this flip phone that still had actual buttons. Now I can unlock this phone with my face. It's amazing.
There's a pizza place with good ratings a 2-minute walk away, I said.
Sounds great.
We walked a few blocks past restaurants, a small grocery store, a flower shop, and lots of brownstones. When we got to the pizza place, we each ordered 2 pepperoni slices and a soda. I asked for pineapple to be added to my pizza. Then we found a nearby bench to sit on. It was such a perfect day out. Sunny, not too hot, and slightly breezy. I loved Boston in the summer.
Did you know they have a Black Heritage Trail around here?
Marcus asked after we spent a few minutes quietly eating our pizza. What's that? I asked.
It's a tour you can take of different African-American landmarks around here. There used to be a community of free Black people in Beacon Hill before the Civil War.
How do you know that?
My parents took me here a few times as a kid, Marcus said. We did the self-guided tour. They liked to talk to me and my brother about Black history growing up.
That's cool. I wiped some pizza sauce off my chin with a napkin. You should show me the trail. We can do it together during our lunch breaks.
I like that idea.
Marcus smiled.
How's your first day at the bakery going?
Pretty good. It was busy up front, which made the time fly. What about you? Do you like working in the kitchen?
Yeah. Vincent's showing me the ropes.
There was that envy again. I wished I could help Vincent mix cupcake batter.
But you know, Marcus continued, being in a professional kitchen is bringing up this dream that I've had for a while. I can't stop thinking about it.
What dream?
I'd really love to open up my own restaurant someday, he said.
Oh, wow. Really?
Yeah. Sometimes when I couldn't fall asleep in my cell, I'd close my eyes and make up possible menus. Or I'd think about what the inside of the restaurant could look like.
What kind of food would you want it to have? I asked.
I'm thinking barbecue. It wouldn't even need to be a big place to start. Growing up, there was this hole-in-the-wall Haitian spot not far from our house. It was tiny inside, only enough space for 2 tables and the counter where they served the food, plus a fridge with beverages. But it was always crowded because the food was so good.
Marcus nodded.
Yeah. A small barbecue spot would be perfect.
I smiled. I love it. You'd have to serve the ribs you made at your birthday party.
Yeah, I think I could do it. Come up with a menu that people would like.
You could totally do it. And then it hit me. An idea so perfect, it made me drop my pizza slice. Chapter 2.
You all right?
Marcus asked as I picked the pizza slice up from my lap. Luckily, it had fallen there and not on the ground. Though I was pretty sure I saw disappointment in a nearby pigeon's eye. I put the slice back into the pizza box and took a couple of napkins from Marcus's hand. What if, I started as I quickly wiped tomato sauce off my jeans, what if we opened a restaurant together? I could be in charge of the desserts. Maybe if it was our own restaurant, I could get back into the kitchen. It would be amazing to be the pastry chef of my very own place. I could definitely come up with a dessert menu. In a barbecue restaurant, we could do, I paused to think, a multi-layered red velvet cake, creamy banana pudding, peach cobbler. We could even do different homemade ice creams. What do you think?
I looked up at Marcus with pleading eyes, willing him to say yes.
Zoe, Marcus said, his face suddenly serious. My insides flip-flopped. He hates this idea, I thought.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.